Welcome to the second part of Gantt charts. In the first part, we created a Gantt chart based on the hypothetical data for days used and days left. Today, we are going to calculate the days used and days left with the help of formulas and also do certain modifications to the existing Gantt chart and make it more informative. So let's start. Hi guys, I am Salim Haider from SHK Excel World. If you want to follow along, download the file from the link below. Here we are going to produce the correct formulas for calculation of days used and the days left. For the days used, I am going to use a combination of if and and formulas. If today's date is greater than or equal to the start date and the today's date is less than equal to the end date. If both of these conditions are true, it should calculate number of days by subtracting start date from today. That is today minus the start date. To ensure that if today date is greater than the end date, it should return the total days. For this, I am going to write another if. If today is greater than end date, it should return all the days which is in the D column. Otherwise, it should return zero. And bracket close, so it correctly calculates all the tasks. So for this I use hypothetical data, because now you can see that against testing, client review and revision, we cannot see the days used because these are zero. For the days left, we can simply subtract days used from the total days. So it's D2 minus F2, and we can copy this to the rest of the cells. We just need to display the data labels for both of these series. Select the first series, which is the days used, click plus and click data labels. Just change the font color to white, also change the font to bold. Do the same with the days left for the first task, which is the understanding. Until unless it coincides with the bars behind, which is the 5th April or the 25th April, we cannot actually identify the precise start date or the precise end date. So for that, I want to have the start and the end date displayed here. We can create another column which shows the percentage of completion. I will name this as completion, and this will be in percentage format. For example, I can say that it is 100% complete, and this one is about 80% complete, and we have done nothing about this or this. So I want a combination of completion percentage, start date, end date into a single cell. For that, we are going to use either concatenate or use and. So name this as value. This will be the value that will be shown at the end of each of the tasks. For that, we will use the percentage completion, then and sign, the start date, then and sign, and then we need the end date. We can see here that Excel has totally ignored the formatting of each of these. So we need to format all of these references. For the percentage, we will use text. Text is a formula that gives you the formatting of a particular value. For percentage, I can give 0% formatting, and now you can see that the first element, which is a percentage, is properly being shown by Excel. I need to separate the percentage from the dates as well. So before this, I am going to insert and inverted comma dash and the start bracket to show the duration of the start date and the end date within a particular bracket. So first part is fairly shown. We just have to format the dates now. B2 is our start date. Again, we are going to use the text, and for the format, we just need the day, DD, and we need the month. 1, 2, 3, and bracket close. For the end date, we are going to give a little bit of space by using inverted comma, space, and then and. And we are going to give a text formula to the end date by using the same formatting technique. dd mmm. And before closing this, we are going to give the closing bracket for the format we used before the start date. And enter. We can copy this to the rest of the cells. Now we want to have this displayed against each of the tasks. For this, we will create a hypothetical series, like just name it as reference and give a value of 10 to each. Go to your chart and insert another series, select data, and add another series with the name of reference and the values which are hypothetical values, just to show the numbers we want to display. Press OK. We do not want this series to be shown. Just go to home ribbon and select no fill. But we want the labels of this series to be shown. Go to data labels, click more options and select value from cells. And here we have to select the value we just created. Press OK and uncheck the value. And for the positioning, we need to have this inside base. Select the series label and change the font to bold. Just stay tuned for the next video, because we are going to do a lot more changes to this. Do subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching.